Hello everyone, welcome to another series guide, and if you're wondering how tappers work and which trees yield what, here's a short tapper tutorial. As of the 1.5 update, there are 6 trees, and you've probably already figured out that they drop various types of wood and products. But there's another way to utilize trees, and that's with those magical tappers. And no, it's not a cute and magical way of saying to tap out for all of you UFC fans. We're talking about a tree sucking device. I'm not really helping my real point, am I? Oh well. You get to craft them when you reach level 3 in foraging. They basically provide an infinite number of resources over time for as long as the tree is standing. For the measly cost of 40 wood and 2 copper bars, you get a lifetime supply of chocolate. Wait, that's not right. I got carried away. But you do get a lifetime supply of syrup, sap and other goodies. The way they work, you simply craft it and while holding the tapper interact with the tree. Devil plays the tapper and the countdown begins. From that very moment, you've officially tapped a tree and can start bursting with anticipation for what's about to happen in a couple of days. Maple trees produce maple syrup and also take the longest time. Canadians must be thrilled for this one. Sadly, there are no pancakes to put it on, but you can craft beehives with it, so at least there's that. Then oak trees yield oak resin and produce a little faster. It's essential for speed growth formulas and building kegs in the future. Ergo, getting those sweet coins by the thousands. Pine trees give pine tar. If you're satisfied with slower speed growth formula and want to make looms and rain totems, this tree is your friend. Now, there's two special trees, mahogany trees and mushroom trees. Mahogany trees give you sap every single day. The amount of the sap varies, but if you're tired of hunting slimes or chopping down trees to get the basic fertilizer, you can just simply tap a mahogany forest and wake with the sweet smell of sap coming from the outside every single day. On the other hand, mushroom trees are kinda oddballs. They can be tapped to yield various mushrooms. The most common harvest will be the common mushroom, which is a great snack when you're feeling down. But red and purple mushrooms can be obtained depending on other factors. The first harvest depends on the season in which the mushroom tree was tapped. It's gonna be common mushroom for spring and summer, but the red mushroom for fall. The downside here is that mushrooms are reduced to stumps during winter, and you cannot tap them at that moment. Tappers that were already placed stay there, but do not produce anything. What can happen is that the next harvest will be so far away, even the elves will give up. But that can be solved by retapping the tree in the spring. Okay, this is not supposed to happen. I have either found a new glitch in the Matrix, or broke my local game. After every harvest, the next mushroom is determined by the mushroom you've just harvested, the season and the date. Here's a little confusing table for you from the official sources. Good luck to anyone trying to time it all. I don't possess the earthly will to do that, I'm afraid. And just hit the like button if that sounds like way too much effort to get some mushrooms. And not the fine kind. There is also an upgrade to all of this to make it produce faster, but since it's a beginner's guide, I don't want to spoil it to all the promising farmers watching this, and I will therefore leave it out. So it would be grand if you guys would not mention it in the comments either. On the other hand, you can comment which tree do you like the most and find the most useful. Now, some of you may be thinking, man, you've missed one tree, how dare you? What about palm trees? Well, nothing. Palm trees decided to betray our little farmer person and they're not tappable. This is not how it was supposed to go. Well, they don't yield anything anyway, so it's pointless, but still. Damn game, I'm losing my credibility here. Interesting fact number one. If the tree with the tapper gets hit by the lightning, it will be destroyed along with everything in it. Interesting fact number two. You can tap trees that don't grow on your farm, so you can easily use the trees at the bus stop or other parts of the map. Interesting fact number three. Tappers produce during winter as well. That is apart from the mushroom one. And interesting fact number 4. Even though maple syrup, pine tar and oak resin are labeled as artisan goods, they do not get the additional value from artisan profession in farming, but instead use the tapper profession in foraging. Thank you for watching this short tutorial and I hope you've learned something. I know I have. Mushroom trees are insane. Good luck timing their harvests, go abuse the knowledge you found here, and I hope to see you next time.